Hello everyone. Dear student, you must have observed your teacher recording the attendance of students in your class every day or recording marks obtained by you after every test or examination. Similarly, you must have also seen a cricket scoreboard. So, look at the scoreboard here. Look at the scoreboard here. Name of the bowlers, overs, maiden overs, runs given, wickets taken. Name of the bowler A, B, C. Overs 10, 10, 10, 10. Maiden 2, 1, 2, 1. Runs given 40, 30, 45, 20. Wickets taken 4, 3, 2, 1. Next, observe name of the batsman, runs, balls faced, time in minute. E, F, G, H. Runs 35, 46, 38, 25. Ball spaced 62, 70, 50, 35. Time taken 85, 71 minutes, 65 minutes, 50 minutes. You know that in the game of cricket, the information recorded is not so simply about who won and who lost. In the scoreboard, you will also find some equal important information about the game. For instance, you may find out the time taken and number of balls faced by the highest run scorer. Every day we come across many numerical data in newspapers, magazines and on television. Similarly, in your day life you must have seen several kinds of tables consisting of numbers, figures, names and etc. So dear students, in the chapter data handling, we shall learn the meaning of data, collection of data, recording of data and organization of data in the chapter data handling. Chapter name is data handling. These two tables provide the data. So data means a data is a collection of numbers gathered to give some information. These tables give data. It means a data is a collection of numbers gathered to give some information. And data handling is the process of gathering, recording and presenting information in a way that is helpful to analyze, make predictions and choices. Data handling is the process of gathering, recording and presenting information in a way that is helpful to analyze, make predictions and choices. Data handling is the process of gathering, recording and presenting information in a way that is helpful to analyze, make predictions and choices. Next we move on to recording data. Let us take an example of a class which is preparing to go for a picnic. The teacher asked the students to give their choice of fruits out of banana, apple, orange or guava. Uma is asked to prepare the list. She prepared a list of all the children and wrote the choice of fruit against each name. This list would help the teacher to distribute fruits according to the choice. Observe. Raghav, banana. Preeti, apple. Amar, orange. Bhavana, guava. Manoj, banana. Donald, apple. Vani, orange. Salma, guava. Likita, apple. Chaitra, banana. Revanth, orange. Radha, apple. If the teacher wants to know the number of bananas required for the class, she has to read the names in the list one by one and count the total number of bananas required. To know the number of apples, guavas and oranges separately, she has to repeat the same process for each of these fruits. It is more time consuming, So Uma writes only the names of these fruits one by one, like banana, apple, guava, orange, apple, banana, guava, orange. Do you think this makes the teacher's work easier? Do you think this makes the teacher's work easier? She still has to count the fruits in the list one by one as she did earlier. Here we want to collect data list if the entire student name and their choice of fruits. Hence, we are recording the choice of fruit of each student. Here, each entry is a numerical fact and it is called observation. After tabulating the data and representing it graphically, we can reach to some meaningful conclusions. Salma has another idea. She makes 4 squares on the floor. Every square is kept for fruit of one kind only. She asks the students to put one pebble in the square which matches their choices. That is, a student opting for banana will put a pebble in the square marked for banana and so on. By counting the pebbles in each square, Salma can quickly tell the number of each kind of fruit required. She can get the required information quickly by systematically placing the pebbles in different squares. Next, we move on to organization of data. Organization of data. Consider one example. A teacher wants to know the choice of food of each student as part of the midday meal program. The teacher assigns the task of collecting this information to Rakshita. Rakshita does so using a paper and a pencil. After arranging the choices in a column, she puts against a choice of food one marked in this way, mark for every student making that choice. Observe here, choice, number of students, rice only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Chapati only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Both rice and chapati, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 students. Umesh, after seeing the table, suggested a better method to count the students. He asked Rakshita to organize the mark, this mark, in a group of 10 as shown below. Umesh suggested choice, tally marks, number of students. Choice, rice only, chapati only, both rice and chapati. 1, 2, rice only I told her, 12 students. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mark 10 as one group. 11, 12. Number of students? 12. Chapati only 14 students. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. 14 students. Both rice and chapati, 18 students. 10 as one group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Number of students? 18. Vani made it simpler by asking her to make groups of 5 instead of 10 as shown below. Choice, tally marks, number of students, rice only, chapati only, both rice and chapati. Vani made it simpler by asking her to make groups of 5 instead of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. Number of students? 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of students 14. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 16, 17, 18. Number of students 18. Teacher suggested that the 5th mark in a group of 5 marks should be used a cross as shown by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are tally marks. These are tally marks. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 5th mark in a group of 5 marks should be used as a cross as shown by this one. These are tally marks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cross mark. Thus, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 shows the count to be 5 plus 2. That is 7. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 shows 5 plus 5 plus 4, we get 5 plus 5 plus 4, we get 14. Now the tables look like choice,
tally marks, number of students. Choice rice only, chapati only, both rice and chapati. Rice only, number of students 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2. 5 plus 5 plus 2, number of students 12. Chapati only, 14 students. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 plus 5 plus 4, we get 14. Next, both rice and chapati, 18 students. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 3, we get number of students 18. The data that is collected for the first time is called raw data or ungrouped data. The data that is collected for the first time is called raw data or ungrouped data. The data that is collected for the first time is called raw data or ungrouped data. When the data is arranged in any data, it becomes grouped data. When the data is arranged in any data, it becomes grouped data. When the data is very large, it is difficult to arrange them in a grouped form. When data is very large, it is difficult to arrange them in a grouped form. In that case, when the data is very large, it is difficult to arrange them in a grouped form. In that case, small bars are used to represent data. Such method is called tally mark. Tally mark. To get the required information, our observation should be recorded. We depict each observation with the help of tally marks. Tally marks are used to organize the observation, record every information by a vertical mark. These tally marks are used to organize the observations, record every observations by a vertical mark. But every fifth observation should be recorded by a mark across the four earlier marks.
The fifth observation tally mark look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Dear students, in this class we learned a data is a collection of numbers gathered to give some information. We have seen how we collect data and each entry is a numerical fact and it is called observation. Next we learned tally marks help us to get particular information from the given data quickly, and the data that is collected for the first time is called raw data or ungrouped data.